In this episode of Dirt Cheap Daily, I'll go through the steps of actually painting your rims. Be sure to check out my video where I go through prepping your rims. Without thorough prep, it doesn't matter how well you spray, so be sure you prep properly. In the last episode, I finished sanding the rims and left them out in the rain overnight. The first thing I do now is grab a rag and wipe the rims down with a mix of lacquer thinner and mineral spirits. You can also use paint thinner, but I found that it takes a little longer to evaporate, and you have to either wipe them down again or wait longer before painting. If you've just finished sanding, I'd recommend rinsing the rims off with lots of water and drying them. After wiping them down the first time, I switched to a microfiber towel and wiped them off again. Using a microfiber towel is really helpful as it doesn't leave any lint on the rim, and it does a good job of picking up any remaining particles. Right before you spray, wipe down the rims one last time. You can wipe it with a clean, dry microfiber, or use a little lacquer thinner. The lacquer thinner will ensure the surfaces are completely oil-free and ready for paint, and it evaporates really fast. One of the biggest things I've learned after spray painting a few cars, and all kinds of parts, is that paint sprays way easier when it's warm. What I do is run the hot water in the kitchen sink until it's as hot as it'll get, and put my cans of spray paint in the water until the whole can stays warm after shaking it a couple times. You can also leave the cans in a hot car, or even use a heat gun to warm them up. Don't boil your cans of spray paint, they'll explode. The paint just needs to be warm, not hot. I like spray painting in grass, because generally there isn't a lot of dust. Try to find a place that doesn't have a lot of bugs, dust, or anything that can fall on your wet paint. Painting under a tree is a bad place. If you're worried about dust, you can wet down the area with a hose to minimize it. The next step to prepping your spray can is to shake it for what seems like too long. I routinely shake my paint cans for 3 minutes before I stick them in the hot water, and then for another 5 minutes after they're warm. These cans have probably been sitting in a warehouse for months, if not years, before you open them up. So spend time shaking them up and getting that paint mixed. With your rims prepped, painting area set up, and cans ready to spray, it's finally time to go for it. Start with a light dusting. I like spray painting the whole rim from one angle, letting the paint flash, and then moving to another angle and spraying it again with a light coat. You don't want to wait too long between coats, because you can end up with orange peel, fisheye, or other surface disruptions that ruin a glossy sheen. If you're new to spray paint, I'd suggest painting with flat, satin, or semi-gloss sheen paints, as they're much more forgiving than full gloss. When you spray, you want to be sure you aren't holding the nozzle down the whole time. If you do, you're sure to get runs. You want to start spraying off the actual object you're painting. You move steadily across it, and end the spray off the object on the other side. You want to paint in overlapping lines, allowing the paint to bind together on each pass. Another tip when painting is to switch hands and even fingers. After even one coat, your finger can get pretty tired, and your paint can get sloppy if you don't switch hands, or if your finger gets fatigued. Another thing I always do is constantly shake the can whenever I'm not spraying. Keeping the paint mixed and warm does wonders for a consistent spray pattern. When I'm getting down to the last bit of paint in the can, I always switch to a new can. When there's so little paint left, the spray can become unpredictable, and you can end up with runs and drips very easily. For intricate rims like these, it took me 3 light coats before they were fully colored. I then put on another 2 full color coats. This Rust-Oleum enamel I'm using can take up to 2 weeks to completely cure, but once it does, it's rock hard. When you get all your coats on, put the rims in a safe place to dry. Once they've dried to the touch, you can move them to more ideal places, like in a bathroom with a fan on, under your bed, or in the back of your Subaru like I did. Here's a dirt cheap tip for faster curing times. Load your rims up in the back of your car and go park in direct sunlight. Let it sit there all day and let the paint bake. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something. Let me know what you think, and in the meantime, check out my other videos on YouTube.